Good morning, students. Welcome to the virtual classroom. We are studying it as the VV theory. We want to overcome the limitations of the Lewis theory as well as the VSEPR theory. We saw it that how can we overcome to the Lewis theory by overlapping of the orbitals, bonding, force of attraction or repulsions, and sigma and pi bonds. Now we will try to get the theoretical explanation of the VSEPR theory for the geometrical shape. So for that case, we are studying hybridization. Now what is hybridization? When the number of the orbitals that are combining together, when number of orbitals combines together to produce new orbitals with same shape and energy are known as hybrid orbitals, and the process is known as hybridization. We are having it as a number of orbitals that are going to combine. They may be two orbitals, they may be three, four, five, whatever the number of orbitals that are going to combine, they are going to produce new orbitals with the same shape, same energy. Those new orbitals are known as hybrid orbitals, and the process is known as hybridization. Now, when this type of hybridization is taking place, what are the features that we can find out in the hybrid orbitals? So, for that case, the main features that can be found in it in hybrid orbitals are as follows. We can have it as, when we are talking about this type of features, what we can find out in the hybrid orbitals, what is the specific character, then in that case you can say that number of hybrid orbitals produced during hybridization will be equal to number of orbitals that took part for hybridization. The meaning of it is, if two orbitals are combining together, then it will produce two hybrid orbitals. If three orbitals are combining together, then it will produce three orbitals. If five orbitals are combining together, then it will produce five new hybrid orbitals. Right? The second factor is, the hybrid orbitals produced during hybridization has same shape and equal energy. That means those orbitals, the one which are the new hybrid orbitals that are produced, they will have same shape. Though one is spherical and one is dumbbell combined together, that means I am saying it about one S and one P orbital will combine. So S is spherical, P is dumbbell, but still the new orbitals that will be produced, they won't be in the form of different shapes. They will have same shape, same energy. Third factor is, these hybrid orbitals will be having it as a more stable bond formation. The hybrid orbitals produces more stable bond than atomic orbitals, producing bonds. So this hybrid orbitals, it says that hybrid orbitals always produces sigma bonds. Atomic orbitals may go for sigma as well as pi, but hybrid orbitals, they are always going to produce sigma bonds. So that means the bond strength will be highest for hybrid orbitals. The hybrid orbitals are directional. They are having a specific direction in the space. Directional in the space. Therefore, they specify the shape to molecules. That is geometrical shape can be explained. So hybrid orbitals, they are explaining us what is the shape of the molecules, because they are directional. So they specific have a maximum force of attraction between the electrons, minimum repulsion between them, and therefore they will specify the shape of the molecules. So these are the main features of it. But is it necessary that any orbital can combine together? No. Some characteristics should be there. Some specifications should be there that these orbitals can go for hybridization or these orbitals can go for hybridization. So for that case, the characteristics that are required for the hybridization, then we can say that characteristic of hybridization that we are going to get it as in the characteristic for the hybridization in the form of the first one, the valence shell orbitals goes for. The valence shell orbitals goes for hybridization, right? So those orbitals which are having it as an outermost orbitals of an atom, they go for hybridization. Second point that we will be required, that is the orbitals that are going for the hybridization, the orbitals that are going for hybridization should have almost same energy. Those orbitals should have same energy. That means you can say that the valence electron orbitals, that is of the outermost, you can say that if 3s is there, 3p, 3d, they can go for combination. But I can't say that 2s and 3p can go for the hybridization, because there is a large energy difference between them. So when you are having it as an orbitals of same energy levels, 3s, 3p, 3d, or you can say that 3d or 4s, they are having almost nearly same energy, they can go for hybridization. But we can't say that 1s orbital can combine with 3p orbital. That is not possible. So for that hybridization, the orbital should have almost same energy. And the third point, that is, it is not necessary that only orbitals with unpaired electrons goes for hybridization, even orbitals with paired electrons also go for hybridization. That means if my 3s orbital is completely filled, then I can't say that 3s won't go for the hybridization. 3s can go for the hybridization, though it is having an paired electrons, still it can go for hybridization. That particular orbital will combine and it will produce an orbital with a lone pair of an electron, right, to specify the shape. So even paired electrons, if they are present, then also they can go for hybridization, right. Now let us understand what are these other different types of hybridizations that we can see it, right. So first of all, we'll see it for those which are having it as an specific orbitals that are going it in the ground state configuration. We will see the electronic hybridization of those elements which are having it as a ground state configuration. So hybridization, the first one, the first type we will see or we will study, that is sp hybridization. What does this means? S means s orbital and p orbital, they are going to combine. So this shows that when one s orbital and one p orbital combines together, they produce two new sp orbitals with same shape and same energy, right. That means these orbitals will have, these orbitals will have 50% s character and 50% p character in it. That means they are having it as an equal amount of s and p character, because one s and one p are going to combine. These orbitals, the shape, the geometrical shape of these orbitals will be linear, that is bond angle will be 180 degree. Bond angle formed by it will be 180 degree. Then how these orbitals are going to combine? So let's take it as an example. Let's take it as an example of BeCl2. Beryllium is the central atom. 1s2, 2s2 is the configuration. It is having two electrons in 1s and two in the 2s. 2p orbital is completely empty. So one of this electron is going into the 2p orbital. So you will be having it as an two valence electrons. Now this was ground state, this is excited state. So these two orbitals, they are going to combine with one another. One s, that is of the 2s, and one of the p orbital, that is 2p orbital. So s and p orbital are going to combine. Now s is spherical, p is dumbbell shaped. But when they are going to combine, they are going to produce two hybrid orbitals with a same shape, same energy, sp orbitals. It's going to produce s and p orbitals. It's a linear shape. So that means what will happen? The boron orbital, boron has got it as in two orbitals. This is sp for boron. Both these orbitals combines with chlorine atom. Chlorine is having it as a the orbital Cl, Cl producing sigma bond, and so Be will produce Cl, Cl linear with 180 degree bond angle. It's going to produce linear shape with 180 degree formation. So that means you can say that this electron is going to combine with Cl, this is going to combine with Cl, right? So that is the sp hybridization, right? Similarly, let's take it as another one. It's an sp2 hybridization. The second one is sp2 hybridization. What does it shows? 1s and 2 p orbitals. They are going to combine 1s orbital and 2p. That means, can I say that it will have 33% s and 66% p orbital character? It will have 33 and 66. Now the three orbitals are combining together, so three new orbitals. Will produce trigonal planar shape. That is, bond angle is 120 degree. The bond angle formed by it will be 120. The example, if we take it as an example, let's take it as BCl3. Boron, atomic number 5, 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. In the ground state, you are having it as an 1 valence electron, right, to complete the octet, but it cannot. So what it is going to do, it is exciting it from ground state, to excited state. It will produce one of the electron to be excited, as these orbitals are having same energy, 2s and 2p, both of them are from the same energy, so that can be done. So here it is going to combine with chlorine, another with chlorine, and third one with chlorine. So that means the p orbital, s and p orbital, s, one is px, one is py. When they are going to combine, it's going to produce three hybrid orbitals as a trigonal planar structure, right? So when you are having it as a trigonal planar structure, that means you are having it as a three orbitals of boron. They combine with chlorine, overlapping with a chlorine atom. It's going to produce sigma bond. This is Cl. So that means the shape we will be getting, it is a Cl, Cl, Cl. Bond angle 120. Right? That is the hybridization that we are getting it for sp hybridization, right? Now let us take it as, in both these examples we took it as those examples where we don't have a paired electron that are taking it for the hybridization. Now we will take it as a hybrid, new hybridization, but such an hybridization in which even paired electron containing orbitals, they also go for hybridization. So that means we will be having it as an sp3 hybridization, where we can show such type of things. The third one will take it as an sp3 hybridization. That means we can say that one is s orbital, 3 p orbital, That means we are going to produce 4 hybrid orbitals with 25% S character and 75% P character. Right? The example that we are going to take it. Let's take it as an first of all example of NH3. Now what does it show? Nitrogen, atomic number 7, 1s2, 2s2, 2p, 3. In the ground state itself, it is having it as an 5 electrons. It does not have any new orbital where it can expand its electron. It do not have any 2d or 3s orbitals. Because if it takes a 3s orbital, the energy difference becomes more, 2s, 3s. So that orbitals cannot combine. So this electron is not going to be excited. But still it is going to take part in hybridization. These are the orbitals that are going it for hydrogen bond formation. So what does it show? S and all the 3p orbitals. They are going to combine together to produce tetrahedral shape. They are going to produce tetrahedral shape. The bond angle formed by it, 109 degrees 28 minutes. Right? But see, what will happen? Actually, when these 4 orbitals are combining together, they produce tetrahedral with 109 degrees 28 minutes. Here also, these are the 4 orbitals. But when it's forming, it is hybridization of the orbitals. It was founded that these are the hydrogen atoms. Hydrogen is having only S orbital. So it's going to have it as an spherical shape. So we got it as an this hydrogen, this one is nitrogen, this one contains lone pair of an electron, the orbital which is having it as a lone pair. And now according to the BACPR theory, there will be a maximum repulsion between it. As a result, when nitrogen is forming it as a the shape with lone pair in place of tetrahedral, it's an arrangement of the electron, the shape formed. Arrangement is tetrahedral, while shape is pyramidal. That is actually the bond angle, it does not remains 109 degrees 28 minutes. Its bond angle is decreased to 107. Why it happens so? Because of, according to the BACPR theory, the lone pair will occupy maximum space. So shrinking of the bonded electrons is taking place. And as a result, bond angle shrinks to 107. Now this particular example was having it as an only one bonded electron. We'll take it as another example. That is for H2O. For H2O. Oxygen, 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. That means it's going to have it as two paired and two unpaired electrons. These two unpaired electrons cannot excite themselves because again oxygen do not have any d orbitals in the 2d, and it can't go it for 3s because its energy will be much higher. So electron cannot go for the hybridization in its excited state. It has to go for these orbitals itself. So this is going to form and bond with hydrogen, but the overall orbitals that are going for the hybridization are 4 of them. So that means when you are having it as an oxygen, its orbitals that are going to combine, they are going to form tetrahedral shape. The oxygen is going to produce tetrahedral shape. This is an oxygen atom. Its two of them are going for hydrogen bonding. Why? Two of them are there with a lone pair of an electron. Because these two of them are there with a lone pair of an electron, what we are getting it? That these two lone pair tries to occupy maximum space between them. As a result, these two bonded electron atoms, that is hydrogens, they will have to shrink. So in place of tetrahedral is an arrangement. And the shape, we get it as bent shape. That means the bond angle is 104.5 degree in spite of 109 degree 28 minutes, its bond angle is 104.5 because of lone pair of electrons. And according to the VSEPR theory, they will occupy more space. So they try to away from one another, so this bond angle is shrinking, right? Though the hybridization is sp3, arrangement tetrahedral, and these were the examples with lone pair of electrons, right? These are the few examples that we saw it, sp, sp2 or sp3. We are having many such type of hybridizations, like sp3d, sp3d2, we can have it as a dsp2, sp3d, dsp3, like that, number of hybridizations. We will discuss about such more examples or more hybridizations in our next lecture. For today, that's enough. Let's first of all understand these three, then we will do it as in rest of the hybridizations also. Thank you.